everybody, it's Lance and Kurt coming to you once again from Austin, Texas, and I'm so happy to be looking at Bill Reeves' new REEVESVERB. It's a old school, but with Bill's take on a, you know, tube-driven spring reverb. You know, over the years, different companies made them, everybody from Fender to Alamo, and I don't know if Marshall ever made a standalone reverb or not. I'll have to look into that. But a lot of guys did in the old days because there were amps that did not come with reverb. What I like about a tube-driven spring reverb that's outboard is that it has a different kind of sound than a verb that's actually built into your amplifier. Now, this thing can be used in front of the amp. It can be used in your effects loop of the amp. Right now, I've got it in front of the park that we're using right here. And, you know, Bill couldn't send us an amp right now because he's backordered. So I'm just using it through one of the amps I have here at the house right now. And it's got a mix, a tone, and a dwell knob on the front. It's got an out and an in, and it's got a foot switch to, you know, stop the reverb from reverbing, right? And so what we've been listening to is my Charles Whitfield Tele. Hear that? Watch, I can turn the tone way down, the reverb, and you get darker response, right? Put it up here in the middle, barely turn that on, and turn the dwell up even more, and you get let me show what it sounds like with a humbucker. So we have my John Paler guitar plugged in here with the Fly Mojo humbuckers tuned to open C minor, capoed up to D minor, and it does this. I use this rig, this guitar, especially for slide and spooky tones. So watch this, we're gonna turn the dwell up so you have longer delay, I mean like a longer spring action, and the tone about a little over halfway up in the mix, a little higher. Watch. And if you want to get like crazy movie soundtrack, you turn your tone up, turn that mix up even a little higher, and you can do. That sound will also get you kind of into the Dick Dale sort of surf land. By turning the tone knob like way down, and it'll kind of push it back and make it a little darker. A little less boing, you know what I'm saying? A little less boing, you know, the reverb springs go boing. when you have the tone way up, all reverbs kind of do that, right? Boing. So you turn this way back and you can get away with, you know, even a little bit more mix, and turn the dwell back a little bit, and you get. So it's an amazing sounding reverb from Bill at Reeves. It's the REEVESVERB. You can get it through Bill at Reeves Amplification. It's a brand new product. I'm digging it. I'd like to have one in my rig because it just, you know, for that spacious sort of crazy movie soundtrack thing, the Dick Dale thing, it kills, right?
It really does.
Yeah, so guys, pick these up from Bill at Reeves, and you can bump on it too much. It's fine. So anyway, thanks for sending it out, Bill. We're going to get this video done to all of you guys. You're going to see it all. Boom, boom, boom. I'm Lance. That's Kurt. This is the Bill Reeves Reevesverb. Reevesverb. See ya. Thank you.